welcome you to our 25th annual Christmas concert. We're so glad that you chose to spend your afternoon with us. I want to tell you a little bit about the numbers that are coming up. First of all, in case it's dark out there and you thought that this was an arrangement, the one we just did by Carol Burnett, the comedian. It's not, it's Carol Barnett, who's a composer here in the Midwest, and the last I knew she teaches probably composition at Augustana, or rather Augsburg College. The next selections we're going to do are A Christmas Carol by Charles Ives, and if you notice, the theme of this concert is Christmas carols, past, present, and future, much as if you were over in the black box watching Bah Humbug at Charles Dickens, The Ghost of Christmas Past, Present, and Future. And it really wasn't much of a challenge because, of course, the Christmas music is so much about traditions and how do we renew those traditions, how do we recycle things and make them always seem fresh and new, and then how do we take and make new things entirely. Charles Ives was an American composer, and he was one of the first experimental composers in the United States, and he wrote this Christmas carol in the early part of the 1900s. But instead of being sort of experimental where you hear things in different keys, it's just a very sweet little carol about Christmas. That's followed by Once in Royal David City. Daniel Coleman is a composer of the present and will be writing things in the future as well. This is a text which is probably very familiar to those of you who are listen to the broadcast from King's College. They always begin with the boy choir singing Once in Royal David City. So that's the text. Dan Coleman has set a very nice arrangement for chorus and piano, a different melody than you heard if you listened to those broadcasts. And then Away in the Manger is a new composition, or say a new arrangement of a familiar carol of Away in the Manger. Ole Yalo is a Norwegian or Norwegian-American. He lives in the United States now, but was born in Norway. We did a piece by his a few years ago that was called Northern Lights, and it was sort of about the mysticism of seeing those northern lights in the wintertime. This one, he sets this text of Away in a Manger sort of as, again, as if it is very mystical, sort of the awe-inspiring event here of the Christ child being born in the stable. And so you hear the choir sing some very peaceful, sort of ethereal chords, and then just a simple melody by four of our sopranos who have brief little solos of the verse. And he does some things at times where he stretches a measure or gives us an extra beat as if to tell us, this isn't so ordinary, this is extraordinary, and you should take just a little bit more time to think about what this is about in this very simple Christmas carol. And then a piece by Morton Lawrence in Sure on this Shining Night.
He feared for our sadness.
tell you a little bit about our next three selections. The Huron Carol is an arrangement by of an old song that was written in the 1600s out of Canada, probably one of the earliest Canadian hymns or Canadian carols. It was written by a Jesuit priest who was working with the Huron people, and it was originally in their language. There has since been a, probably it was a French translation. This is an English translation. And again, this is an interesting mix of old and new. Eleanor Daly, I'd like to say, is a contemporary Canadian composer and conductor, and she did this nice arrangement of it. I also discovered that, how many of you are friends of the Crash Test Dummies? In their 2002 Christmas album, they have a nice arrangement of this. So always refreshing some of the old things, this old song from Canada. I want to just tell you a little bit about the text. And of course, the Jesuit missionary there preaching to the Huron people, trying to explain to them about Christ. So there are some interesting substitutions. Instead of the babe being wrapped in swaddling clothes, he is wrapped in a robe of rabbit skin. Not born in a manger, but a lodge of broken bark. Instead of shepherds and the kings, they're portrayed as chiefs from afar, and they bring him fox and beaver pelts instead of gold, frankincense, and myrrh. So we hope you'll enjoy that setting of the Huron Carol. Following that is the a piece by Stephen Paulus, a wonderful composer from the Midwest. Some of you probably know that he passed away in October, but he wrote for the choir and the voice so well. For many years he was a composer in residence and did a lot of commissions for Dale Warland. And so this is our commemoration in memory of Stephen Paulus, a wonderful setting of a tune that came out of one of the hymn books of the United States, of the Southern Folk Harmony. And then with a text by someone that has done a frequent collaboration with Stephen Paulus, Dennis Russell Brown, The Road Home. And then after that, appropriately enough, a wonderful spiritual about the road home, about what is at the end of the road. Ain't of that good news? So first the Huron Carol.
Before the light of stars grew dim. Thank you.
Some of the nostalgic Christmas literature, I've selected the Little Drummer Boy. This was originally known as the Drum Carol, and it was written by Catherine K. Davis. It got to be really popular when a fellow by the name of Harry Simeone, who was a band arranger, was asked to put an album together for a recording company, and he had heard of this song, so he arranged it for a chorus, put a group together called the Harry Simeone Chorale, and did that. A couple other songs that he made famous from about the same era were Do You Hear What I Hear? And then a little bit later we're going to do his arrangement also of 'Twas the Night Before Christmas. And then let's see, I gotta check my script here, make sure I covered everything. And we're also doing Santa Claus Is Coming to Town, which is a very popular song, and we hope you enjoy the selection of some traditional and some new arrangements of these old favorites.
Thank you.
Go back a cue. I should tell you, as long as I've got the opportunity now, how wonderful it is, and thank you to all of you who were our campaign for the future. And you saw a note in the program here about the Steinway that we were able to get and replace our 30-some-year-old Baldwin, and it's just a wonderful instrument. And our lights here that allow you to do anything, go backwards. And the nice thing about the lights for the choir and for a lot of our actors is we've gone to LED lighting. So we don't have the hot incandescent lights for the choir or for, so it's just, and it's energy saving too. So if you were a contributor to that, and it's probably not too late, or for the or for our annual fun drive, thank you very much. And
Santa Claus is coming to town. Santa Claus is coming to town.
You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
He's making a list, checking it twice. Gonna find out who's naughty and nice. Santa Claus is coming to town. He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake. He knows if you can battle good, so be good for goodness sake. Oh, you better watch out.
You better not cry. You better not cry. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town.
You better watch out. You better not cry. You better not bow. I'm telling you why. Santa Claus is coming to town. He's making a list. He's checking it twice. He's gonna find out if you've been naughty or nice. Santa Claus is coming, coming to town.
He sees you when you're sleeping. He knows when you're awake. Oh, you better watch out. You better not cry. You better not pout. I'm telling you why.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
He's making a list and he's checking it twice.
Santa Claus is coming to town.
He's gonna find out.
Thank you.
were like roses when kissed by the sun.
His nose like a cherry, all wrinkled with fun.
His droll little mouth was drawn up like a bow.
The beard on his chin was as white as the snow.
Endeavoring to find things that were from Carols of Christmas Past, I thought, I wonder if there's a good, well-known Bach piece that we could do. And Bach wrote a Christmas oratorio, and I didn't find anything that I thought would fit the mood. But I did find, in searching, a wonderful combination of Bach plus O Holy Night. So you will hear in this O Holy Night, it starts out, sounds like Jesu Joy of Man's Desiring, but it's woven together very nicely with the simple O Holy Night. So something from the from a past a long time ago and something a little more recent, the O Holy Night setting. And then a wonderful arrangement of the First Noel, and again, that's a quite an old traditional carol or Christmas hymn. And Dan Forrest is one of these composers who maybe it certainly fits into the category of a present composer, but he's doing lots of arrangements of American folk tunes and original compositions too, of quite some magnitude. But he's a wonderful arranger and just did an outstanding job breathing some new life into the First Noel. So, O Holy Night first.
Thank you.
Christmas stuff has to do with tradition and nostalgia. So shamelessly, I programmed something from my nostalgia, and that is the Luther Choir song that they usually close with. And it's got a wonderful message to it, and it talks about having something to sing about and always being able to sing. And one of our choir members, Skip Jewett, is going to share this with the choir, and it's by Robert Shaw, who is just a wonderful choral director and a philosopher, and he has something very special to say about music and about singing. Skip, would you?
We sing too damn much just for the fun of it, not nearly enough for the must of it. I don't think anyone should sing if he can help it. I'd like to belong to a choir that sings just because it can't help it.
So thank you for coming, and have a wonderful Merry Christmas and holiday season. We'll close with O Lord God.